I am out here at the Mississippi River Valley. Got my F2 Lycan Shepherd Ka-Bar, German Shepherd Lobo with me. Beautiful day. I think some people had a party here. Tammy and I just finished cleaning the mess up there from whoever left it. Come along. Again, there's the beautiful Tammy.
Hi, guys.
We're at the little-known hidden entrance to the off-leash park. This is an old storm sewer I used to go in a lot as a kid. You can lift that grate up. You can go all over the underneath the city on these things. Right here we have the lock and dam in the Ford Parkway Bridge running across it. We're currently on the Minneapolis side. Over here is St. Paul. How you doing? K-Bar is still blowing the remnants of his coat. Of all my dogs, he has probably the thickest undercoat. Beautiful, huh?
Yeah. The water looks almost down.
Yeah, the water levels do look down. You can tell by how high the island's sticking up right now over there. Wow.
Crazy, because we had a whole bunch of rain.
Yeah. Well, that'll work its way here probably in the next day or two from up north. Somebody was doing some bottle rockets here. Beautiful. Yeah, this is all sandstone here. It's pretty soft. You can scratch into it very easily with a rock. There's a lot of caves in the area that people dig because, again, you can scratch into this stuff pretty easily. And there's just a beautiful cool breeze. I don't know if the it feels really good. I don't know if camera's picking it up, but moving through the trees right now, it feels really nice.
Come here.
Can you get a shot of him jumping over? See if we got a good thumbnail there. We'll see. Again, this is kind of a hidden back entrance to the off-leash dog park. Not a lot of people know about this trail because it sits behind that big storm sewer there that most people don't go beyond. It's one of the reasons why I like the trail is because even on a busy day today when there's lots of people out in the area, it's like we have it all to ourselves, yeah. It's just beautiful. Huh?
Yes.
We got some new merch in the store. Made some grill pimp gear related to my new cooking series on the channel. We call it the grill pimp because Rob has many grills he uses to make the bacon. Scent mark in here. Must be smelling something on that log. Scratching and rubbing on it.
Birds are happy.
Good shot, Keith. Come here, Lobo. Lobo. He's behind me, stinging nettle. I don't know if you can see him. Lobo. Where? Lobo, come here. Try to get a good thumbnail if we can. That's where we should be on the boat. Somebody down there fishing. Spent a lot of time fishing on the river here as a kid. They make a pretty mean beer batter. Panoramic 360 of the area. It's beautiful, huh? Yes. Again, I love this trail because few people know about it, and it's really beautiful this time of year. Again, you're walking along the ridge here just above the river. They're happy. Yeah, the river's really down, huh? I like it. We'll have a lot of beach to walk along now. Like, Dad, where's the stick?
There's a whole bunch.
Yeah, I see him. I think that's what he's telling me. Ooh, look how fast that current's going. I don't think he saw where it went.
Like, wait a minute.
Lobo, it's right there. Hey! There he goes, I think he sees it now. Good boy! The current's moving fast today. Jeez, it grabbed that stick, it took it down.
I think it got on there.
Hey. frame a little bit so it carries it back this way.
Yeah.
Because it's moving pretty quick. Good boy.
It's moving very fast.
Yeah. As a kid, we used to swim across the river all the time, and you know, you'd start about here and you'd end up way downstream before you got to the other side. All right, come on. Used to water ski on the river too, up by Hudson. Hey, what are you rubbing on? God. Yeah, he's found something dead to roll on. Yep. Leave it to K-Bar to find a dead fish. Thanks, buddy. Come on. Leave that alone. No more canine cologne. That's the one downside to this time of year. Lots of dead fish on the beach. For the dogs to find and fragrant themselves with. Good boys. Ow! Stop smacking me with that. He dinged me. Nice. God, I love to be on a boat like that today.
Great.
Perfect. Yes, it would be. I don't know if I mentioned it before, but we have some new Grill Pimp merchandise on the channel for the new series on the channel, Cooking with My Friend Rob. Also made some new First 508th Airborne logo with just the red hand logo, which I actually like quite a bit. I put some of those up on the channel too. I'm looking forward to getting my samples of both. I thought they both turned out pretty good.
Me too.
They're actually my two favorites shirts on the site now. It's pretty cool. Again, it's a big sandstone wall that people have carved. Oh yeah, there's always new stuff on it. People are always carving new weird little faces and all kinds of other stuff. Let me get a shot of you in front of it, Tim. Hopefully we got a good thumbnail there. That was a cute chat.
Yeah, so cute.
Amy's got an Instagram that's always linked in the description along with mine that has all kinds of stuff from these hikes. If you enjoy the hikes, you might enjoy the Instagram accounts that are full of pictures from them. Oh God.
Numb.
Tammy's wondering why her hand stinks. She forgot that K-Bar was just rolling on a dead fish, and she gave him a kiss too.
Numb.
Nice. No kisses. No kisses from me, sweetie.
Oh, come on.
K-Bar marked you as his.
Right.
You can save all your kisses for him. What was that you said in the other video? Stinky.
Stinky.
Damn it, Lobo.
No, he got me.
He keeps beating me up with that stick. Somebody throwing something in the water for their duck. They must be over by the hollow tree over here. Look how far the hollow tree is up off the water now.
Wow.
Isn't that funny?
Yeah.
For those who follow my channel regularly, I'll show you just how low the river is right now compared to recent times when we've been here. This big hollow tree, which has been in many of my videos.
Oh, wow.
Oh, you can see a light coming through the top up there.
Is that board still there?
It doesn't look like it. But this hollow tree, I think last time we were filming here, the water was up to about right here. K-Bar, no! He's found a giant dead carp. K-Bar, no! Don't roll on the dead fish. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Oh, enjoying the day. Unfortunately, my dog found a big stinky fish to roll on.
Yep.
Canine cologne. Handsome dogs.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. You coming, sweetheart? They won't bother him.
Oh, no
worries. K-Bar, come on. Good boy. Come here, Lobo.
Ah.
Come on. What? Yeah, buddy. Yeah, I like it when the water's down because we have a lot of nice beach to walk across here. There's such nice sand here. It's that really fine, I don't know, I'm probably dating myself, but
ash.
Yeah, it's like ashtray sand. I don't know if you remember when you were kids, all the buildings had ashtrays outside of them for people to put their cigarettes out before they went in, and they were always full of this kind of sand. Come here, K-Bar.
Hi.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, buddy. Come on. People fishing across the river over there. Yeah, an absolutely beautiful day. Was it about 75, 80 degrees?
Yep.
Perfect.
75.
Yeah, perfect weather for walking along the river here. Mm-hmm. It's a nice cool breeze in the air. Doesn't get much better than this, huh? How you guys doing?
Hey, hey, good.
Come on, K-Bar.
What kind of dog is it?
It's a German Shepherd cross.
Okay. What's the other cross?
Husky. Oh, thank you. It's just a lot easier to say that than explain the intricacies of the Lycan Shepherd Project.
Hi.
Nobody wants to hear me explain for 5 minutes that to everyone I pass, so I usually just say he's a cross, which is true. He has Husky and Malamute and Blue Bay Shepherd and German Shepherd and various other things in him. Hi. Hi. Beautiful day, huh? Hi.
Hi there.
Hi. Hi.
You guys stay down, please.
Oh, there we go.
Hey, buddy.
Hi.
How you doing?
Pretty good, over you?
Oh, enjoying the day.
The circle.
Again, this is a great place to socialize your dogs. Been taking mine down here every day, just about, since they were little puppies. Well, that's documented on the channel if you want to see the process I use to develop an off-leash dog like these guys. Yeah? Is that one of those big pileated ones?
I hope so. I've only seen a few.
Yeah, we haven't seen that many this year.
Pretty amazing how big they get.
Yeah. 28 minutes in. We'll stop this soon and I'll start a clip too. Maybe we'll go down to the point here and then
head back.
Start a clip too for the hike back. How you doing? You got the right idea with the hammock.
Yeah.
Come on, K-Bar. Good boy.
Oh, perfect day.
It is. Yeah. It really is. Yeah, Tammy's off for the next few days on vacation. So, we've been taking advantage of it.
Right.
Come on, K-Bar.
Wow, it's like somebody chiseled it.
Oh God, look at that. That's a big dead catfish.
Ooh.
Don't let K-Bar find that. Yeah. Yeah. Because there's been a lot of boats, and so the wakes have been doing that. Ooh. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, enjoying the day. I'm getting a workout walking on this sand. Got my head up beach a little bit. That one's digging a hole. He catch you with the stick? How you doing? Enjoyed the latest edition of the cooking channels, the cooking shows. I've often thrown different content on the site just to keep things varied and interesting. My dog content will all stay the same. Just keeps things a little fun for me filming wise. This is my hobby, so that's why you get different things. The music videos, for example, I use as free ads for the channel. I use already posted hiking footage, usually after that's been posted, and then I cut it into some music videos, and those attract new viewers who wouldn't normally see my channel because it's a dog channel. And I used to play drums in various punk and hardcore bands in the early and mid 80s. I love all kinds of music, and I like sharing a lot of different music with the subscribers, especially from some of the smaller known bands on YouTube that I think deserve more exposure than they're getting. So it allows me to do all those things. And then I have all the various hiking videos, training videos, feeding, raw feeding videos, etc. A little something for everyone. Over 1600 plus videos on the channel, so if you see something you don't like, look around and you'll probably find something you do. Sure. If not, just click off and don't watch. Just don't complain. My sciatic is acting up a little bit. Hey, come here. Oh.
Yeah, I kissed it.
No, I'm talking about Lobo. He just shook behind me and got my whole back wet. No. He probably won't see.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Here, turn around.
Thanks, buddy.
It's like sand and water.
Yes.
He's your own personal mister.
Yeah, it's just beautiful out. Breeze feels so good, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know if you guys can hear it. There's just a beautiful, cool breeze blowing through the trees.
See how tall that's getting now.
Yeah, all the stinging nettles got so tall here now. Hey.
Dude.
You all right?
Jeez.
Way to go, Lobo. Hope you're pissing Mom off. When Mom's not happy, nobody's happy.
Right.
True story.
True story.
Yes, I did. Almost tripped over that little root there. Yeah, look how low this is now, Tim.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, you said we're supposed to get rain on and off today, tomorrow?
Well, it's like, I doubt it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just supposed to be like, I guess the days go on, the more sun we get.
Let's stop here. Lobo. Lobo. They don't want your stick. Come here. All right. We can get a nice shot here. Like, subscribe, and share. Hit that notification bell down. God, you stink like fish. Is that fish on the end of his muzzle there?
Stop.
Like, subscribe, and share. Hit that notification bell down below. You'll get email notifications when our new videos come out. That's all.
Bye, guys.
See ya.